Now there's tons of speculation about who could possibly be added in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. But this time around, the speculation seems to be pretty lacking when it comes to third-party characters due to Sakurai saying not to expect too many newcomers this time around. But there have been two third-party characters that have been getting lots of attention. Simon Belmont was one of those two, mostly due to him being included in a leak that correctly predicted other information such as Ridley, the Ice Climbers, and all the characters returning, plus the game's name. And despite not appearing in the leaks, Heihachi Mishima is the other big one. Why is he showing up in so many people's predictions? He's not exactly the most requested character like Sora or Banjo and Kazooie, so I'm here to fill in the gaps. Why is Heihachi Mishima such a big prediction for Super Smash Bros. Ultimate? Now before we get into the reasons why he will likely or should be included, let's go after the naysayers, the people who don't believe he'll get in or the people who don't want him in. Now back in the days of Smash 4's development, Sakurai actually intended to put Heihachi in the roster, but cut him because he couldn't think of a way to implement his movesets or playstyle. And that leads to people thinking, if he didn't work before, what makes you think he would work now? And to that I say, remember when Ridley used to be too big? Also, did you know that in Super Smash Bros. Brawl, Pac-Man was considered for that game, but was cut for the exact same reasons Heihachi was cut in Smash 4? And where's Pac-Man now? In Smash. Not only that, but all of Pac-Man's moves are from his own games, aside from his grab. They didn't have to reach and pull across Namco's history to grasp at straws and get him in. It just took a little bit more thinking and planning, and the same could be done for Heihachi. And the second reason why a few people think he shouldn't be in is because they assume he would be a clone or echo of Ryu, which couldn't be further from the truth. Heihachi has different kinds of throws, different kinds of parries, he has ki charging, counters, wave dashing. Tekken is even the source of Smash's rage mechanic, so some of Heihachi's mechanics could revolve around that. Plus, Heihachi has a lot more to work with this time around, thanks to Tekken 7, which has been playable since the beginning of 2015 in the arcades, months before Sakurai was working on the project plan for Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Heihachi now has power crushes, which are basically like a super armor, a rage drive, and rage arts. So Heihachi could have his own little personal rage mode, whether you turn the mechanic on or off in the rule settings, similar to Lucario's aura. But unlike Lucario, Heihachi could have a unique mechanic where he could sacrifice this damage boost for his rage drive. Just like in Tekken 7, he could either save the extra strength he gets from rage, or sacrifice it for one super powerful kill move in his rage drive. Now on to the positives, why he should and will likely be in. Let's go with the evidence first, things that make him likely. The first piece of evidence is one I just went over. It's that he's following the same path that Pac-Man took when he was considered for Brawl. Kinda funny how they're both Namco reps, which leads to the next point. It's that Bandai Namco is the only third party, aside from Square Enix, that has only one rep, while all the other third parties have more. The difference between Square Enix and Bandai Namco, though, is that Bandai Namco is actually assisting with production of the game. And that's the third point. Bandai Namco is back producing, so maybe as a gift for helping, Sakurai will include another rep. Since Tekken is one of Namco's most massive franchises, even doing better than Pac-Man, it's a no-brainer that Tekken is next in line to receive a rep. Several mechanics from Tekken are even already implemented into Smash Bros., like Rage Mode, which I mentioned earlier, and the new Squad Strike Mode. While that didn't originate from Tekken, it does bear a striking resemblance to Tekken's team battle. I'm sorry, that was a bad joke. The fourth point is that there seems to be a trend of Mii Fighter costumes becoming full characters. We've seen it with Crom, we've seen it with K. Rool, and of course the Inklings. Heihachi is also in that group. Not to mention he is the only Mii Fighter outfit to appear in another character's reveal trailer. Just like Geno from Super Mario RPG was the only Mii Fighter outfit to get its own eye catch. These Mii Fighters are pretty special, don't you think? And finally, the fifth point, which is quite a bit of a stretch, but it's still something interesting that I noticed. Tekken series director Katsuhiro Harada has stated many things regarding Smash Bros., even lending assets and team members to the Smash Bros. Team. But simply working with Sakurai isn't enough. There are plenty of third-party characters in Smash with directors or creators that aren't that involved with Sakurai anymore. An example being Yoshinori Ono, who is a big part of Ryu's inclusion. He doesn't follow Sakurai, and Sakurai doesn't follow him. Yet Tekken's director Katsuhiro Harada and Sakurai follow each other. So it's possible they're actually pretty good friends and appreciate each other's work. Similar to Sakurai and Hideo Kojima, despite Kojima not being a part of Konami or Snake's inclusion anymore. So it's just interesting to know that these two are working close yet again. But now on to the more personal reasons why I think he should be in. Now, I used Bandai Namco only having one rep despite being the only third party to actually help with production of Super Smash Bros. As evidence for why Heihachi should get in, but I also think it's a reason for why he should get in. Now, there are a couple other speculated Bandai Namco characters, but they don't quite have the same pull. There's of course a character from Dark Souls. It's another one of Bandai Namco's biggest franchises, but the M rating might be a problem. Sakurai already has Snake and Bayonetta, I doubt he'd want to push it any further. And while it does sell a good couple million units, it doesn't quite rake in the big bucks like Tekken does. It sells about 3 million, 4 million units, while Tekken typically sells around 5 million, 7 million, or even up to 8 million with Tekken 3. Then there's Lloyd from the Tales of series, which has even less luck than Dark Souls when it comes to sales, barely even scratching 1 million most of the time. Now, the little demand for Lloyd may seem pretty odd for those who don't exactly know the history. Back in the day, there was this super popular Flash game called Super Smash Flash. And when I say super popular, I mean super popular. People loved it, and you guessed it, Lloyd was in there. No one ever brings up any other Tails characters, any other Tails games, it's just Lloyd, Lloyd, Lloyd. Enough to where he even got a Mii costume in Smash 4 too. But with that, Tails and quite a few other remaining Namco franchises just don't quite leave the same impact that Tekken did. People just liked Lloyd in those Smash Flash games. Point number two is that Tekken is the face of 3D fighters. We've got Ryu representing 2D, why not get someone to represent 3D? Virtua Fighter's dead, Soul Calibur's been dead until just recently, same with Dead or Alive, Mortal Kombat went back to 2D after only being in 3D for a little bit. Meanwhile, Tekken's been kicking and thriving in 3D the entire time. Point number three is that Heihachi is not only the face of 3D fighting games, but likely the face of fighting games in general, as Tekken is the number one most successful fighting game franchise of all time. It sells more than Street Fighter, sells more than Mortal Kombat, even those popular anime fighting games like Dragon Ball, it even outsells Super Smash Bros. Itself. The fourth reason he should be in is that Tekken is no stranger to Nintendo crossovers either. Tekken Tag Tournament 2 had its own Wii U edition which had exclusive Nintendo-based modes and Nintendo costumes. Then of course there's Pokken Tournament and Pokken Tournament DX, and then finally, Heihachi, Crom, Lucina, and Fiora were all in the same game in Project X Zone 2. And then of course the fifth reason he should be in is because he's Heihachi, man. He's another great video game baddie. He'd be an excellent rival to Ryu, he's got a great personality, taunting and laughing at people as he knocks them off cliffs. Heihachi is not just another martial artist in a gi. Heihachi is special. He's an icon of fighting games and an icon of video games. And that's why I believe Heihachi should and will likely be in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate for the Nintendo Switch.